In this video, I'm going to share with you some of the top ways, top methods that have been researched on, studies have done, about how you can learn more efficiently and really ensure what you are learning sticks. Okay, let's go. Oh, if you haven't, hit that subscribe button, support me, and also leave in the comments other topics you want me to cover. Okay, now let's go. The first one on the list is called retrieval practice, and this is the concept of remembering at a later time. So how exactly does this help? For one, recalling an answer at a different time than when you're actually learning the material actually helps reinforce learning more efficiently than just trying to study in your textbook. This is similar to the concept of flashcards. Actually writing down what the answer is on a flashcard and continuing to repeatedly look at it and remember, quiz yourself, is way more effective than simply looking, reading, and thinking you know this. If you are someone who practices retrieval learning, it is more likely, based on studies, that you will remember this information, retain it for a longer period of time. This is something that I did a lot when I was studying in university, especially with flashcards. Little tip, Quizlet is amazing for flashcards. At the time when I was studying, it was free. I still think they have a free version. Anyways, we're getting sidetracked here. I'm sharing on screen here some ways which you can implement retrieval practice. The first one is utilize practice tests. Use practice tests or quiz questions without looking at the books or notes. Another way is to make your own questions. Essentially, like, be your own teacher. Create questions you think that would be on a test. If you're in a study group, you can do this in a group setting where others make questions that they think might be on a test and quiz each other. And the way that we have spoken about so far is flashcards. Create flashcards, but make sure to practice with the retrieval technique. Instead of just flipping a card over right away, write the answer down and then check. Next on the list is the LEITNER system. Speaking of flashcards, this system is a system that utilizes just that. In this system, you will have different boxes and keep your flashcards in each of them. Now, how exactly does this work? Every card starts in box one. If you get a card right, you can move it to the next box. If you get a card wrong, either move it a box down, or if you are just starting, keep it in that same box. I'm trying to be interactive, you know? According to mindedge.com, the LEITNER system focuses on spaced repetition and actively recalling the information. And what this does is it allows for our brains to absorb the information and process it more efficiently. I'll put a little schedule on screen here. So every day you will have box one, every 2 days, box two, every 4 days, box three, 9 days, box four, and 14 days, box five. Maybe you're a visual learner like me, and if this is the case, mind mapping is a great way to learn. Mind mapping is a technique that allows you to visually organize a diagram in your mind. So visualize this. First, you write a word in the center of a blank page. From there, you write down the major ideas and keywords and connect them directly to the center concept. From here, other ideas will continue to branch out. So how does this help us learn and remember things better? Mind mapping is related to how our brains actually store and retrieve information. Mind mapping your notes instead of just writing them out, what it does is it can help improve your reading comprehension. It also allows for you to see the big picture by communicating the hierarchy and relationships between the concepts. So mind mapping is very helpful, especially when you are studying topics or learning something new. A lot of times with technical topics, that there are different hierarchy points to it, there's different connections to it, and it's a great way to visualize it out. Here's how to give mind mapping a try. First, grab a blank sheet of paper and write down your study topic, such as JavaScript. From there, connect your main ideas to the main topic. Then, as you can visualize it out, you can connect subdomains, sub-branches of supporting ideas to your main branch. What I like to do when I've mind mapped in the past is use different colors for them, for each branch and the connections. No surprise here, sleep is critical for your brain function, memory function, and learning. Yet, why do we always push it off?
Taking you on a journey today.
Studies have shown that studying right before you sleep actually helps improve memorizing or understanding what you are learning. According to a researcher from the University of York in the UK, when you are awake, you learn new things, but when you are asleep, you actually refine them, making it easier to retrieve them and apply them correctly when you need them the most. This is important for how we learn, but also how we might help retain healthy brain functions. So think of it as sleep is a win-win. You get to relax, go to sleep, but you also are helping improve your brain. No one wants to study more than they need to, let's be honest here. So using some of these techniques to learn more efficiently will not only help you retain information, have better recall, but it will help you save time in the long term. Too many of us have been learning in the wrong way, and I say that meaning we get taught one way to learn and that's the only way we can do it or that we've ever done it. We need to start looking for other alternatives, other ways to learn based on research and studies in order to find what works best for us. At the end of the day, if you are someone working in tech, you're going to be consistently, constantly learning. So it's really important to try out some of these methods and find what works best for you. All right, I think I'm done my work here for the day. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Let me know down below if you have tried any of these learning techniques, and I'll see you all soon.